Nice Ferrari. Now all I need is my Hawaiian shirt. Unfortunately, the last one didn't get saved. Somebody threw up on it. It didn't look too bad on the shirt, though. Hello, everybody. Sparkster1701 here. We're taking a look at another Legacy figure. We got a Stunticon around this time. This is Wild Rider. Wild Rider, of course, was one of the original Stunticons from the Generation 1 era. Here's his figure from back then. In the original continuity from Generation 1, Wild Rider functioned as a terrorist amongst the Stunticons. Of course, today that's probably something that wouldn't really fly. Though I don't know, it's kind of one of those gray areas. One of the biggest flaws with Wild Rider, now with all the Stunticons in general, is the fact that they all do suffer from some mental deficiencies. In Wild Rider's case, he has a severe phobia for quiet. Wild Rider cannot stand being amongst the sound of silence for any length of time. In fact, too much of it tends to drive him into a frenzy. So it's been often known that his leader, Motormaster, a professional bully in his own right, has been known to order the Stunticons to remain quiet as possible in order to drive Wild Rider into a frenzy. So, in a lot of ways, that also makes Wild Rider rather less useful as a soldier, since he can't be used for stealth operations. But at any rate, let's have a good look here at this new version of Wild Rider, and I definitely have to say it does pay a nice homage to the original toy, and it does its own thing as well. And of course, the Stunticons will be able to form Menasor, their combined unit. Wild Rider here will become a leg. And yes, Motormaster is out. I do have him. And he will be reviewed at some point later this month. But however, Menasor will not be reviewed until I have all the Stunticons. Because as of this filming, I do not have Dead End. He supposedly is out, but I've yet to see him in the stores. And it's probably not going to be until next year before Breakdown gets released. Breakdown is going to be in part of the Legacy Evolution line, but he'll still have a Legacy box, so that if you're one of those that collects them and keeps them in the box, then the box will match. So Hasbro's at least doing that much for you fans. Alright, now let's take a look at Wild Rider's accessory. He comes with two guns. They are exactly the same. So you got the hole here on the one side, and they got a post on the other side. A nice painted scope on the top. It definitely pays homage to Wild Rider's original gun, since as you can see, it is relatively in the same basic shape. So it is nice that somebody is putting some attention to detail. Now, Wild Rider can hold his guns, like you saw him there, as separate, one in each hand, or You can combine the guns together and form a double weapon. However you choose to display it, it doesn't really matter in the long run, but you at least know you have the choice. Alright, now, let's take a look at Wild Rider's articulation. And he has about what you would expect. So I'm sure many of you can guess some of it just by looking at him. But at any rate, you can turn his head from left to right. It's not on it. Well, it's a bit hinged. Hold on a second. Phone's ringing. Okay, sorry about that, folks. Now, as we said, the head can look side to side. It's not really on much of a hinge, so it does not rock up and down. His arms can raise out about so far. They do rotate all the way at the shoulder, but you do have to move it to the side to get past all the car kibble. His arms do bend at the elbow 90 degrees. They just are a bit stiff. There we go. There we are. One elbow bent 90 degrees. And he does have a swivel at the bicep. So he has G.I. Joe style battle grip. He can be twisted at the hips. So Wild Rider can do some dance moves there. You can spread his legs apart into a full splits. He does have something of a thigh cut. You can raise his leg at the hip 90 degrees, and you can bend his leg at the knee 90 degrees. So all in all, he's got relatively decent articulation, except hampered at his arms. Okay, to transform Wild Rider, it's not nearly as simple as the Generation 1 version. But it's also not too horrendously difficult. The first thing we do is we take his hands and you're going to fold them into his arms. Love that ratcheting sound. Then next, we're going to fold down his chest plate here. It'll bring his head with it, which is what we want. Because you're going to fold his head inward. And then we will close it back up. Just exactly like that. And now we're going to come here to the side. Well, one thing you should do is at least get the arms straight and probably line them up so that they're right next to the body. Come back here to the back. We're going to raise up this front section a bit. Just enough to get it clear of the windscreen, so that way we don't have any trouble putting the fenders to the rest of the front of the car. And then, once that's attached, we just slowly but surely wiggle it all down and snap it into place to help form the front of the car. Then, of course, you can bring the windscreen down and snap that into place. Then next, we will turn him around at his waist so that his legs are backwards. Fold up his feet like so. And then while we're going to spread his legs apart a little bit, they should open up. There we go. Easiest way to do it is to slide a finger in underneath. But once we got them opened up, you can connect his legs together. Disconnect his knees and fold the entire thing over and around. We have to spread the back wheel section out a bit to get it clear. You just get the legs lined up to form the rear of the car. And then you can fold the panels back down underneath. And that will complete the look of the car. And there is, of course, Wild Rider's car mode. And aside from the stripe along the side, it does bear a fair amount of resemblance to the Generation 1 car. The G1 version was based to look like a Ferrari 308. The 308 was famously seen in the 1981 film Cannonball Run, as it was the car that Dean Martin and Sammy Davis Jr. drove throughout the film. But it gained more prominence in the 1980s television series Magnum P.I., as that would be Tom Selleck's car to ride around Hawaii in. But of course, those Ferraris were in the traditional red color. Although the dark gray on the original and the black on the modern one doesn't look too bad. Some might say that's blasphemous for a Ferrari, but seeing as I can't afford a real Ferrari to begin with, I don't much care. Now, of course, you can turn the modern one into an attack mode. Since he has two holes here in the back, you can insert the guns individually. Or if you want, you can combine them and stick them in just the one hole. That at least looks a little bit better than the Generation 1, where you get this obnoxiously large cannon that appears out of nowhere. All in all, modest improvement. So now we get to my thoughts. I like how Wild Rider turned out. He is one of my favorite of the Stunticons. I don't know why, just always has been. So I was eagerly anticipating his release. So I'm kind of thankful he was the second one to get released. Didn't have to wait too long for him. His character, it's still questionable, but there is no shame in hiding these kinds of characters from our youth. There are terrorists out there. There are evil people out there. We should not hide that fact from our children, because we're not doing them any favors by denying that evil doesn't exist. Evil exists in all forms. And there's nothing wrong with letting a child play with an evil character. But all in all, this figure isn't too bad. The only real complaint that I may have about it is how they set up the windscreen here on it, since it folds outward when he's in the robot mode, and it's a very thin piece of plastic. So I can imagine there's going to be a fair amount of Wild Riders that have that broken from rough play. Now, hopefully that won't come into any of the equation when he gets combined into Menasor. And that we'll have to take a wait and see on until we have everybody. In the meantime, that concludes my review of the Legacy version of Wild Rider. I hope you all enjoyed it. And please do remember that if you like the content that we feature on this channel, please do remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. This is Sparkster1701 saying I will catch you all later.